Hi, Drita. It's Saturday, the 9th of September, 2017. You are flying off to Abu Dhabi to go to Bangkok in Thailand.
Disaster struck almost immediately. While attempting to withdraw the local currency baht from a cash machine, my card was eaten. We initially thought it was stolen, but eventually asked the kiosk and thankfully it was found. Crisis averted and we managed to get to the hostel safely. The following day almost began with a scam. A local man told us that our destination, Wat Pho, was closed, but we were a bit more savvy than them and were able to make it to the 80,000 square meter Buddhist temple complex. We saw beautiful architecture and figures, including the famous reclining Buddha at 46 meters long. We also joined in the Buddhist ritual at their ordination hall, known locally as a ubersot, and even had
a traditional Thai massage.
How was the massage, guys?
Interesting. Some painful parts, which I think may be less painful later.
At least on the pleasure was for me, so the pleasure was for the masseuse.
We ended the day with a brief exploration of the local area, seeing a gorgeous sunset and a bite to eat before bed.
Your second day in Bangkok, and you're in the Grand Palace, founded in 1782, and residence of the royal family.
We had a bit of spare time in the evening and so decided to go to a shopping centre where we discovered an anime and manga store and, much to Kamran's annoyance, spent a little too long there. Unfortunately, Shyam wasn't feeling well that day, so Kamran and I ventured alone. The floating market was a stark contrast to the shopping centre we visited the night before, and much, much cooler. The variety of things you could purchase, from knives to clothing to fruit, was outstanding, not to mention the novelty of being on a boat. For dinner, we found this hipster place that claimed that the food would detox you, whatever that means, and had a brief experience of Bangkok's nightlife at the infamous Khe Son Road.
Morning, Trito. I am now an Arab prince, and it's Wednesday, 13th of September. Today, we are flying off to
Siem Reap, on our way to the hotel, driven in a tuk-tuk.
As we were tired from the flight, we just rested that evening and set off early the next day. We spent two entire days at Angkor Wat in an attempt to see both sunrise and sunset, unfortunately achieving neither due to cloud cover, so get ready for a long video montage. I've had the privilege of travelling to a lot of places around the globe. Many of those travels are featured on this channel and many more to come, but by far Angkor Wat is the most phenomenal landscape I have ever had the honour of laying my eyes on. Anyone who's watching this video who hasn't been needs to go. Post-pandemic, of course. These clips simply do not do it justice. Angkor Wat was built in the 12th century, originally created as a temple to Vishnu, the Hindu god of preservation, but later converted to a Buddhist temple, although it holds true to much of its Hindu roots. The name Angkor Wat translates to City of Temples, and the complex stands as the largest religious land structure on the planet, measuring at 1.6 kilometers squared, with dozens of temples within, each one special in its own unique way. Some temples have whole stories inscribed into the walls. Others have been invaded by forests. Some are surrounded by lakes, while others hold them within. It is quite literally where Indiana Jones, the Temple of Doom, was filmed, and you genuinely do feel like an explorer uncovering the secrets of a forgotten history.
Morning, Rito. It's Sunday, the 17th of September, 2017. Your first day in Vietnam and your first day in Hanoi. Behind me, you can see a great view of the city, and we've just been on our walking tour.
For the remainder of the day, we simply soaked in the local atmosphere, ate a little and chilled, ready for an early coach ride to
Halong Bay. There is a fantastic view, as you can see behind me on this boat.
Halong Bay was absolutely stunning. It has it all. Emerald seas, limestone islands, caves and rainforests. We ate some delicious seafood, even making fish rolls of our own, and also attempted to fish, but predominantly caught plastic. We had a brief kayaking experience where I managed to both lose my knockoff Ray-Bans and cut my knee open, which was not pleasant, but overall had a great time living on a boat for 2 days.
Our fourth day in Hanoi, and today you are on the Red Bridge at the heart of the city.
Next on the list was Ho Chi Minh Museum, which was unfortunately closed by the time we arrived, so instead we went back the morning after, learning much about Vietnam's modern history. Then, Kamran took us to a great barmy sandwich restaurant, and finally onto Hau Lo Prison, historically a prison used by the French during colonization, and later by North Vietnam in the American War, where it was dubbed the Hanoi Hilton. On a lighter note, in the evening we went to a very entertaining puppet show and then ate dinner with Andrew, a British friend we made in Hanoi. Now, onto our final destination of the tour, Ho Chi Minh City. On the first day we visited Notre Dame Cathedral Saigon, then the central post office, attempted to do some pull-ups at an outside gym, balanced some coconuts, bought some random Pokemon snack which also came with a token, and then off to Independence Palace, which is a very cool and historically important location, being the site where the Vietnam War ended. We then visited the War Remnants Museum, which has some horrific images which I'm not going to share. It's absolutely abysmal how Agent Orange was used in the American Vietnam War by the Americans. Anyway, that night we ate some great food, went on a mini night out, and I got hit by a motorbike. This trip has not been kind to me on the injury front. Then, the next day we visited Saigon History Museum, explored the city a tad more, saw some awesome skyscrapers, ordered a tailored suit, and met up with Shyam's university friend Locke.
Afternoon, Rito. It is Monday, the 25th of September, 2017. Your third day in Ho Chi Minh, and today you are at the Cu Chi Tunnel, where the Americans invaded the Vietnamese farmers in the south. Behind me, you can see a shooting range, but we are not currently shooting. It's quite expensive, firstly, and secondly, guns, not the best thing in the world. And secondly, this is where the farmers would build underground tunnels to live and then come up during the night to do normal life stuff.
And that's it, our Southeast Asia 2017 tour. I thoroughly enjoyed it. I got to see some truly amazing places, learned a ton of history and geopolitics, and built some great memories with even better friends. 4 years later, we still make jokes about Kamran purchasing bananas at Angkor Wat, which I won't go into, or his knockoff night toucan shirt, or his Gap Year trousers, or even his adventures while on nights out, which I definitely will not repeat for the record. Come to think of it, a lot of these jokes are at Kamran's expense. See you in the next one, Idrito.